Let's talk about the entropy increase or randomness increase in our system. Let's assume that this is a cylinder we have, and inside this we have some gas like air. All right, so let's say we have a piston here, and this is not a reversible process. All right, so this piston has some weight, and this there is also some friction between the wall and this piston here. So what we do during the expansion of this process, we want to do very fast. So what we do is, let's say we added 1500 joule of heat energy here. We added 1500 joule of heat energy here. At the beginning it has x liter gas. Now after adding 1500 joule here, what happens is this gas expands and this piston moves up. So let's say this is the cylinder, and this gas, the piston moved up due to the expanse of the of this gas. All right, so the piston moved up like this. So see that the randomness now increased. At the beginning the gas was contained in very small volume. Now the volume increased and the molecules are more randomly distributed there. All right, so let's say this volume now is y liter. All right, so how much heat we added to go from here to here? It's a 1500 joule. Let's say we represent this by Q, but we added this heat in irreversible system. This is not reversible system. All right, so let's say the temperature here at the beginning was 25 degree centigrade, which is equal to 300 Kelvin, and also the temperature is still the same. Let's assume that the temperature is still the same, so that is also 300 Kelvin. So how to calculate the entropy or the randomness increase here? So in this case it is a little bit tricky. So entropy change or entropy increase is equals to, since this is an irreversible process, during this irreversible process what happens is, this is one part of that heat and another part of heat is here. The when this piston moves up, there is a friction here, and because of that friction and the weight of this piston, what happens is there produce some heat here, also produce some heat. This is one heat, and some heat is produced here due to the friction and weight of this piston. So the entropy increase is equals to this heat, that is 1500 joule divided by the temperature 300 Kelvin plus the some amount of heat is produced here, some small amount of heat is produced here. So this is the entropy increase due to the friction of this piston with the wall of the cylinder. So this is, if it were a reversible process, we just have to do 1500 by 300, we will be done. But since this is irreversible process, this is like a everyday process, in this case the entropy increase, a randomness increase, just cannot be the heat we added divided by the temperature. We must have to add another factor here. That factor is, where does this factor comes from? This factor comes from the heat generated during this expansion due to the friction of this piston with the wall of this the cylinder and the weight of this this piston. You see that? So the entropy increase in irreversible process, that is randomness increase in irreversible process, is the heat added divided by the temperature plus the entropy increase due to the production of the heat due to the friction of that piston with the wall. So this is also entropy. In thermodynamics we call it entropy generation. So if we are designing some machine, some system, we always have to minimize this entropy generation process. So anybody who can make a system with a very small entropy generation, that can win the prize. All right, thank you very much.